So the first thing we're going to do is create a new repository. I'm calling it Go on Azure Demo, making it private, adding the Go default gitignore. We will create this and let's clone it. Git clone, bang. Then we will go into our folder, Go on, and we will initialize the Go module system using our URL here, bang. And then let's open this folder in Visual Studio Code and get started. Let's create a new main file called main.go, and let's add some code. Let's print some stuff to make sure this is all working. Hello from Go. And here we can do go run main.go. So far, so good. Next up, let's install the Gin web framework. So we will do go get this. Doopy doopy doop. They're very good. Here we can get our router here, router gin.default. And let's set up the root path to return some JSON. So we can have a function here with context, gin.context, and we will return some JSON with HTTP status OK, and an object here. Let's call this foo bar. And at the end here, we will start the application like so. OK, so now we've imported the status code and the gin framework, and we have decided to launch the app on port 8080. Now we can do go run main.go. And in our browser, head over to localhost 8080. And we can see that we've got some JSON output. Fantastic. OK, so let's commit and push this to git star commit m first commit push origin main. Very good. And now we can see that we've uploaded some code. Cool. So because we want to push this to Azure, we're going to go and create a new Azure app service. We will create a, we can add this to an existing or create a new resource group. So let's create a new resource group for this. We'll call this Go Demo. Very good. And we will call this the same as our Azure repo, Go on Azure Demo. We will be pushing code for this, not using a Docker container. And we can also select the .NET 6 runtime stack, even though we're not using .NET. And we will set this in UK South, so I can use my existing app service here. On deployment, we're not going to set up continuous deployment here. We don't need network injection. We don't need application insights. Don't need any tags. And then we're going to go and create a web app. Very good. So let's keep that going. So there are two things we need to do here. Let's create a build folder. This is where our compiled output for the Go app will be. And in here, we need to create a web.config file. This web.config file is going to be used by IIS to run the Go application. So let's have a look at it. We're using an HTTP module called HttpPlatformHandler, like so. And this will launch the application goapp.exe. But we need to build this. So let's create a GitHub action. And this will be under .github. And we will create another folder called workflows. And in here, we will call this go.yaml and get started in here. So the name of our GitHub action is going to be build go app and push to Azure. And we're going to run it on push for the branches, main, like so. And our jobs is going to look like the following. We're going to build on Windows because we're deploying to the Windows app service. Our build step is going to look like this. So we're running go build in the command line, and this will compile to build/goapp.exe. And then our final step is to push to Azure. And the name of our app service here is Go on Azure Demo. is going to push everything that's in the build folder, including the web.config file. And we're going to use the web app publish profile's GitHub secret to do this. So to get your deployment GitHub secret, over here on Azure, we go to the resource. We hit get publish profile. We can open this, copy and paste everything here. And over on GitHub, we head to settings, secrets, on actions, and we create a new repository secret. And this is called Azure Web App Publish Profile. So we paste in there, hit add secret, and that's been uploaded. Now we can deploy to Azure straight from GitHub. So that is the first thing we need to do. We also need to update main.go to deal with the fact that it's going to run on Azure. Using the HttP platform handler module, this will provide a new port on every time the application is run. So we need to load this from an environment variable. This is our port here. The port that we need to run the application on is set in the environment variable HttP platform port. But obviously we still want to be able to run this locally. So if port is empty, we'll set it to 8080. And here we will use the port there. Very good. We can quickly confirm that this still runs locally. Go run main go, like so. And over here, we're still getting our JSON. Very nice. Okay, so let's add everything here. And then we can git push origin main. And that has now been pushed. So what we will see is that the GitHub action has been kicked off, and we basically grab a cup of coffee and sit tight. There we go, GitHub Actions is underway. We can see that it has built go-app.exe in the build folder, and here it is deploying to Azure with our app name, and it's deploying everything in the build folder. Very good, so we have now deployed to Azure. So let's refresh this. And if we click this URL, we should see our application is now running on Azure. Very good. Very good. So let's now add an HTML page. So let's change this to JSON. So we need to visit slash JSON. And let's create a template. So let's create a folder called templates. And in here, we will create a file called index.tm. Very good. So in here, we will create a simple HTML file, which obviously has HTML. And we can do a nice head here, like so. And we're going to add Bootstrap like that. Here's our body. And let's have a title there. Very good. So in our main Go program, we will need to load all of our templates. And in the root of the application, we will do router.get slash function, like so. And we will return HTML with the status code status. OK. This is a template. And here's our object that we will be using. And the title is Hello from Go on Azure. We can save this and run the application again. Go run main.go, and if we refresh our localhost version, we now have an HTML page, which is a bit prettier. And of course, we can get our JSON. Very cool. So what we will need to do is copy the templates from this folder into our build folder during the deployment stage. So to do this, we will need to create a new step here, which is to copy static template files. If we don't do this, the application won't be able to start because it won't be able to find the templates. So let's add all this again, git add star, git commit m, HTML template, git push origin main, grab another cup of coffee. Now it's attempting to deploy to Azure, and we can see that it has copied the static file over here to build. Very good. What you'll notice is that it has failed to deploy the second time. So let's take a look at this error and figure out why. The key here is that it's failed to change a file that is currently being used. So because the Go app is running, it won't let us replace it. Now, normally, with .NET apps on Azure, it creates a file called app-offline.htm, and the ASP.NET Core module notices that this file has been created and stops the application. This isn't natively supported using the HTTP platform handler, so we're going to have to replicate this functionality within our Go application itself. So here is one I made earlier. Let's save that. So let's step through this code and show you what's going on. So here we create a new FS Notify watcher. Under here, we get the working directory, so that's where the app is running. Make sure that it monitors it. And if the event name of the file ends with app-offline.htm, we exit the application. This will gracefully shut down the Go app when app-offline is placed in the directory next to it, signaling that a deployment is happening. So let's save. And let's push this, git add star, git commit m, add app offline, support, git push origin main. Now, while that is going, because the app is still running, so this deployment would fail, we do need to stop the application. So let's stop that in Azure. And you can see here that it's down. So we're deploying to Azure, and because the application has stopped, it will work this time. Very good. So if we start the application and head to the link, we'll see that we have our HTML page. Very nice. So next up, let's add an image. So we'll call this public. Here's one I made earlier. Let's paste that in there. Very good. So in index.html, we will put an image in here, and we'll call this public tran4png with alt text. And we need to set up the JIN framework to serve static files from the public folder. So let's stick that in there and run the application. Again, run, go run main.go. Hit refresh on our local version, and we can see that we have our image. Very good. So again, we will need to update our build pipeline to actually also copy static files. So we can copy this build step here. Copy static files, public files. There, public, close the app. We can do git add star, git commit m, and image and static file hosting, git push origin main. Take a look at our GitHub actions, and we can see that it's kicked off again. Now, the application is running on Azure this time, so this is also a test of our app offline support. We are building. And we can see here that it has successfully deployed, even though the application was running, which is good. And now we can refresh the page, and we will see that our image is now being served. Fantastic. And of course, our JSON endpoint is also working. That was a demo on how to get a Go application with the JIN framework running on Azure. I have a repository for you here called Go Azure App Service. This is public. And this essentially has everything you need to be able to do this yourself, including the GitHub workflow and the alterations to main.go to get this working. If you found that useful, don't forget to star the repo. Link is in the description below. And like and or a subscribe would be much appreciated. Thank you for watching. Take care.